In this video, I'm going to be showing you how the data transform function can be used in Rguroo. The data transform function enables you to construct new variables using R scripting language and transform existing variables in any given dataset. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using the student survey dataset from the Rguroo user's guide repository. If you need assistance loading this dataset, please reference our video, Uploading a Dataset from an Rguroo repository. From the data toolbar, click on the functions menu, then scroll down to transform. Then within the dataset dropdown, select student survey to load our dataset. An alternative way for opening Rguroo's data transform dialog box would be to right click on the dataset you wish to transform. Scroll over to the functions option, then click on Transform. You'll notice by using this alternative way, the dialog box opens with the dataset of interest already filled in. Let's start with an example of breaking up values of a numerical variable into interval categories. The R function cut is useful for this purpose. In the student survey data, the numerical variable fastmph represents the fastest speed in which a student has driven a car. The range of these values are from 20 to 160. By hitting the green plus button, Rguroo can create a new variable. We will call this new variable speed group. This variable will categorize the student's speeds into three groups: 20 to 79, 80 to 99, and 100 to 160, with corresponding labels cautious driver, speed racer, and daredevil. While we could perform this transformation in a single line of R code, I'm going to show you this example using three lines of code. First type, interval equals C parentheses 20, comma, 80, comma, 100, comma, 160, end parentheses. Hit enter, then type speeds equal C parentheses quotation cautious driver end quotation comma quotation speed racer end quotation comma quotation dare devil end quotation end parentheses. Hit enter one more time and then type cut parentheses fast mph comma breaks equal interval comma labels equal speeds end parentheses. The first line of code assigns the four cut points to the variable interval. The second line specifies labels for each group to be created. And finally, the third line uses R's cut function to create the variable speed group. Now let's hit the preview icon to see our results. Here we see our transformed dataset with the new added variable speed group. I'm going to click back on the Basics button to show you other features of the Data Transformation dialog box. Should you want to drop any variable you've created, you can simply drag the variable into the Dropped Variable box in the bottom left corner. However, variables in the Drop Variable box can be restored by dragging them back up to the Variable box. You also have the ability to reorder your variables by dragging the variables in the order you want them in. I would like our new variable speed group to be at the end of our dataset. Now the variable HRSTV is a numerical variable that represents the number of hours a student watches TV in a day. I would like to exclude this variable by dragging it down to the Excluded Variables box. However, I'd like a new variable that represents the hours of TV watched into the number of minutes a student watches TV. Click the green plus button again and label this new variable minutes TV. And then type for our transformation, capital H, R, S, capital T, capital V, star for multiplication, and then 60. Hit the preview icon to see our new results. I've now transformed our data the way I see fit. Let's save the results as an Rguroo dataset using the name Transformed Survey. By default, Rguroo saves the R scripts we've used to create this dataset and adds the transform icon next to the dataset name. When saving in this fashion, you can make future edits to your transformations and new data structure. However, unchecking the parameters checkbox saves the dataset as an independent dataset. In either case, the newly saved datasets are available throughout the Rguroo application. You can also download your transformed data directly to your computer as a .csv file. Just click on the Download Results icon in the upper right-hand corner. If you would like further details and examples on how to use the data transform function, we encourage you to reference the chapter, Data Manipulation of a Single Dataset, from our user guidebook.